Okay, so I have various small things that I think important to know, so I'll try to do them now. So we've seen just a bit of arithmetic on this. One thing we saw yesterday in an example is that if you do it, a division of integers, like something like that, an exact division, but the outcome is a rational number. So since types are always given by the types of the arguments, it always has to be a rational number. Usually you also want to be able to do integer division, where you just throw away the remainder, and so that simply reverses the slash symbol. So there you get an integer. And if you make it non-exact like that, it's still the same value. And of course, you also want to be able to see the remainder. In that case, well, that's the traditional C symbol, the percent. So there you get the remainder 2, and just for fun, because we can, let's do both of them at the same time. So the division and the remainder, that's actually one operator symbol there, like that. And then the result is a pair. Now we will get to two pairs a bit later on, but you can take a pair apart using a left expression if you want to get at the individual components. And so in principle, this is slightly more efficient because the division, it has both informations anyway. And so it can return them. And in general, functions can return multiple results if they have, just like functions can take multiple arguments. And it's exactly the same mechanism that's used, it's forming tuples. But that's so much for now. Well, just some, this is just a bit fun. If you consider something like this, 0 minus 4, that's of course minus 4. People say, why would you write 0? It's the neutral element, so why do you write it? And so similarly, if you have 1 over 6, that's 1 over 6, so why should you write 1? It's a neutral element. So you can also do just monadic division by 6. And I think this is much, much more, you can also write, I think, this, but it's negative power of an integer. That it doesn't do. Because it's powering of an integer. So if you take an integer power, usually you get an integer. So it can't just make a rational because this time it saw that the exponent at runtime was negative. So this one doesn't work. And so you need to do division here. That's just because, so if you want to know, you can ask what type power it is. You see it's lots of things. The very first one is due to the power inconsistent, which of course is mathematically not always true, but it's useful to have. If you really wanted as this result as a rational number, then you could of course make it a rational number first. And I think we need parentheses because powering higher precedent. And for example, I've I've managed to hang up at this, I think. So that's yeah. Oops. I think some other implementation I never tried it. So very curious. Powers of rational numbers don't work. Okay, so of course we're going to fix this on paper, not right now. Um, So that's rational numbers. I think I've recently added, no, there's no decimals. There's a very simple function to write a rational number in decimals as a string, because that's not a certain point happens. But it's not. Okay, that's rationals. So get a bit about vectors. I think we've already seen vectors and rows of integers. And so if you type something like that, that's a row of integers. If you are asked, no question mark here, it's the value, and it's a row of integers. And if you want to convert it to a vector, you need a cast to a vector. And it puts spacing, the vector spacing is large enough to get the largest coefficient, which is actually for vectors, it's not really useful, but for matrices. There's not so much. Let me give this vector name. See? One of the things you can do with vectors, well, there are several ways you can handle vectors. You can add them as vector addition. B plus B. Twice that. You can multiply them by like that. If C is scalar products, then so if you do B times B, that's the scalar product in itself. You can also, just like integers, you can divide them, and then what you get is a new data type, which is called RadVec. That's a RadVec. It's a very simple type for doing rational linear algebra. So actually, if you want to work over a field, you can do that. It uses a very simplistic representation as an integer vector over a common denominator. It does ensure that the denominator is minimal and positive. If you say that plus 0.5, okay, then it knows how to combine the denominators and simplify. And so you can. This is an important type for Atlas because it comes up in parameters. For one thing, so in Atlas, vectors are important because they represent z to the n. So they can be elements of x upper star or x lower star. And as Jeff mentioned, maybe we should have two vector types to distinguish these two. I think it could be done, but we need to change some internals in order to make that work. But anyway, those are always integers. And if, for instance, if you take a row, it's the half sum of the positive roots, and it's not always an integer. So then we need a rational vector for row. Yeah? If I type row, I guess it's there. So you can be row for root atom, or root atom on the right side. I really don't know what that really means. Or you can have the row of a very large thing which we use for extended parameters. I don't know either. If you want, you can. But anyway, what I want to say is the very first one. If you take the row of root atom, that's a vector. It could be integer, it could be half integer, but since you can't tell, the type is always vector. One of the things you can do with fractions, if you have a rational number, so let's go back to the beginning. Let me do something like that. That was the same, actually. There's something which is not integer. And so you can, of course, if you could just flip the slash, then you get an integer. But if you want, if you already have a rational number, then there's I think there's a function for that will do this. So that's the integer part. There's also this, which is maybe a bit more surprising. But I think this is actually implements for, that is, do an integer division by an integer. So that means, well, it means what you think it means. Take as many copies of one up to the value of this rational number, and forget any remainder. So that's the same as for. And just to show that it works correctly, if you take minus that, since it's floor, it should not be minus 15, but minus 16. So, see, that's right. So it's really, and that's a general property of this integer division. It always takes the remainders to be positive, I think, or maybe of the same sign as the number by which you're dividing, which is almost always positive. It's not as often in computers that it takes the sign of the number before it is divided. And in particular, the modulo operation is what it mathematically should be. If you're doing mod a positive number, the result can be from 0 to n minus 1. It won't be negative because you're dividing a negative number. You do a negative number modulo something. So that's okay, and it works for rational numbers, as you can see it works. Similarly, and if you go back to V, okay, says, so you can see that's doing an error. So that's a rational vector, and I think there the same operation applies. So that's again the floor operation. It's a rational vector, and you take the floor of all the coefficients. So if you think of it, there are natural definitions. All this is available. So this floor, I don't think it's called floor. Is it the same thing with floor? I don't know. Maybe it's not. Yeah, it is. Okay, so. So floor is also defined in this case. And that's another operation that comes in handy sometimes. And for instance, it's capable, if you know that it's a rational vector, that the denominator is 1, it allows you to convert it to a vector which has the same value. Okay, so that's vectors. Now I'm coming to matrices. With the Radfax, so vectors correspond to rows of integers, and Radfax summary corresponds, so if you get back to this rational vector, you can actually convert that by a simple cast to the row of rationals. And then it will put rational numbers in every position, and sort of type for the rational. So that's one place where conversion also works, and it works in two directions. The difference is that the Radvec is a limited precision type, and rationals can really be very large. Or let me just show you two integer very much divided by 3 as well. But there's a slash somewhere. I think it's square. So it can easily become very large, and so you can play around with that. Rationals are unbounded precision, but Radvex will overflow and give you problems. If for instance you want to convert, it's just a single rational, so I have to put it in this, and if I do that, it says integer value to big for conversion. Cannot make that into the list of just that rational number, cannot be represented with a rational number. Okay, so matrices, we already saw some of it. Let me do something here. So, just the matrices are, of course, very often needed. For instance, when you talk about involutions, there are matrices, and we do lots of things with involutions. I'm not going to have any answer in another one. So, okay. So that's a matrix. So as long as matrices are small, we have no problem computing their determinant. That's three. So now you might want the inverse of A. And it says, well, that's not invertible over integers because map is an integer type. And so inverse, looking for an integer inverse, but it doesn't exist. It, on the other hand, there is a variant inverse. Okay, and this is a kind of, this is not really a built-in type, it's a kind of rational matrix representation, an integer matrix over a common denominator, which is 3. So here the determinant was 3, and you can use that as common denominator. But it actually always uses the smallest denominator, which can be smaller than any type.
Excuse me, Mark, did you change this data type recently? You got rid of the slash?
No, this is just the invert function from BASIC. It doesn't actually come from the RadMat script.
Oh, so
there's a RadMat. There is a RadMat script which has a different. Well, it has actually a data.
So this isn't the RadMat that I was talking
about.
No. Okay.
And I think numerator denominator is the previous result, so to catch them, and then I do n over d. I think that's a function defined in RadMat, and now you see it has a kind of, so if I type what the type is of this beast, and you see it has three components, not string and int, and well, the string was really added to make it different from a map and an int. Because pair types, if you, for instance, want to do a negation operation on this thing, there is already a subtraction of a map from an int. And so you can now safely, minus, oh, there's lots of them. But so there's a built-in minus, which here somewhere, mod in mod, that subtracts the multiple of the identity matrix from A, and now there is a different one, this is here, one of them. But actually, see the one which has the second argument, A, it must exist. Yes. Also, this mod string in is kind of type which was introduced in a script in order to be able to work, for instance, to compute the inverse of this matrix and then multiply that inverse matrix with things. And so it simulates, it's not a built-in type, but it simulates a type that simulates to do these things. Still don't see where it is. So that would mean that I
look for match string int.
Yeah.
Is there about halfway down the page?
Match string int with a web string with a.
No.
Anyway.
What is there?
Oh, it's just match string int with nothing down the page. That's. Oh, match string void. That's okay. I don't know. It's a big call. What's in the script? So. Anyway, so built in there's just map and this invert function with no function for this, and if it's invertible over the rationals to get information back.
What is the other number after the inverse?
It's,
So it turns into this matrix.
This is an integral weighted and a common denominator.
So the actual inverse is that integral matrix divided by d times the identity.
And there was this little trick is to, this is a triple of values that certain functions will recognize. For instance, I could take the opposite, yeah, that's what it was looking for. And then you see that we'll have switch the signs in the integer matrix, but it's kept the 3. So that's, and so if you want to add things to this, actually I think you could probably, you kind of add an identity matrix with just an oversight, because you can do that with A with this, and so you can pretty well say A minus 2, for instance, that subtracts twice the identity matrix from A. And that's really very handy if you're doing minimal polynomials and trying to do such kind of stuff, to see if this is 0. Do have to do this, right? Minus sign, plus sign here. So that's kind of polynomial arithmetic with matrices. It's a lot easier if you don't have to write, because there is a way to get the if you want the identity matrix from scratch, you have to type something like this. That is 2, so I actually need 3. The problem, of course, if you give no other arguments, it has to know the size of the matrix, but if there's already a matrix to the expression, it deduces that you probably want the same size identity matrix. That's a radio reason that makes sense.
So one side comment here. This D, for a long time, I thought was the determinant. But then there's a comment in the AT file that says, this is not the determinant of exclamation points. And it's not the determinant.
Yeah. Actually, if you say so, we say this one times 4. But sometimes you have to do it from the right side. Okay, and so if you take invert of this beast, not so hard. But the determinant is 64. So the inverse is the identity of the 4, not what. You could write it over 64, but you don't need a determinant. In general, you don't need a determinant to get the inverse. It tries to get the minimal, but it's, you shouldn't try this for very large matrices. I think this is not one of the strongest points. But in Atlas, we've rarely used very large matrices. I mean, it's usually the rank is the group, so 8 or something or less. But so the inverse function, because the inverse function does a kind of invariant factors computation. It's all over the integers, but it can. I've seen in large examples that it can completely blow up in terms of computation. So there is recently implemented ordinary Gaussian elimination to do what everybody learns in the first year in your algebra, to invert the matrix correctly, but that involves rational numbers. Here we do it over here. Okay, another thing, A is still a matrix. So this is just, if you're doing first year in algebra, you want second year maybe. This character is a polynomial. Well, here, again, there is no built-in data type for polynomials, so it uses vector, and you need to read it as minus 3, minus 18, x minus 8x squared plus x cubed. So it gives you a polynomial, but only the coefficients and always from 0 upwards. So that's just for fun. I'm not going to do much with that. Maybe someone sees the roots of this polynomial straight away. So sometimes you want to, V is still a vector, yeah. And sometimes you want to operate by modifying, we see you could build a vector by a loop where every iteration of the loop gives one coefficient of your vector. But sometimes you just have a vector and you say, well, okay, I want to add, let's say, 3 to the second component of this list, and then you can actually do this. Modification operator becomes, I think we've seen that, the column equals, which is pronounced becomes, and so you can do that, and so I replace the 4 by 3, the value of the evaluation is 3, but 3 has become, the index 2 is the third component. I always have to recall that it starts at 0. So I got what I asked for, but I thought it was changing the form, but it was changing. So if you if in a loop you want to modify by small modification to vector, you can do that. I should note that there is no notion of subobject at all in this language. So it's just the object that gets assigned is V. There is no object V2. Like the syntax V2 becomes 3 is just a way of assigning a new value to V, which is just the old value, except that at index 2 it's 2 times vector.
How do we delete this error?
How do you delete? Okay, if you really want to, you say forget V. And now V doesn't know anything about V. So this modification of V also works for matrices. So let me add here. I do a bit of matrix computation. Set made is 2 times V is not 5. Matrix. And say I want to add an upper triangle with some entries. So I have here, say 2, 4. That's in the last column. M 2, 4. So this is a variant with the syntax of 2 indices. Actually, M 2, 4, that's just 0. It's actually this 0, this one, 4, and if I want to become a little bit of 1, okay, to do that, and now again, this is an assignment to the whole value of m, like this one, and let me see why it's actually here. Sometimes you make an error, and you're saying, for instance, I say that I want to do the same for three, and I forget the colon, it just says false. This is something, if you don't say colon, it tests the quality. And as a special feature, if you say, well, I want to do that, and I don't want to see m, so now you're throwing away the false value, and this arrives. It happens to me very often in programming, I forget the colon, and I use an assignment before a semicolon, and that's a special feature, it doesn't want this particular value to be thrown away. The value resulting from an equality operator, it says, you probably meant because. So that's just to help you find programming errors. Yeah?
No.
N
bracket
1, 3
is the 1, 3 entry of M.
Yeah. So let me see. So I still didn't modify what I meant is this. Let me just do it.
Huh? Oh, is it 2-4 entry?
The
2-4
entry.
So let me put in another value here. This is what I meant. I want to put in 3, and then I want to see the result. Okay. Now, so you see that I put in 3. Let's do it. So this is a very normal thing, to do an assignment and then to do a semicolon. But the equality test of the semicolon just doesn't want that because it's so silly to do that and probably didn't. So, thank you, Alec.
Mark?
Yes?
If you have a vector, how can you change that to a matrix?
A vector to a matrix as a matrix in one column or something?
Yes.
Okay, so that's a good question, and the answer is simply, so V was a vector? No, I forgot V. So let me the vector again. That's set V is vec. And you want a matrix with one column. That's very simple. You say that you want a matrix, and you put V at the top. And say you want 2V as another column. So basically, if you take a list of vectors, of course, if you don't make a matrix of that, it's just a list of vectors. Just a list of two vectors. But if you then say I want this as a matrix, then it will always put them as columns.
Think of matrices as areas of vectors.
Yeah. If you try to convert
the brackets around the vector, otherwise it will not work.
Yeah. If you just say matrix of a vector, that will not work. Well, I found a vector, the key didn't make, and there is no implicit conversion map. We could do it, but I mean, it's just typing, the whole difference is just typing this around it. So, if you want a row, then one of the obvious things to do, that's the transpose operation. It's a prefix operation, but every symbol that's a map operator can be used as a prefix, so it can be used infix or prefix. And often we give a special meaning to the prefix, so normally it's maybe not used for a transpose, but it's very handy to have it. And I think because transpose cannot be done with anything other than a matrix, it would even work in this case without casting to matrix. If you take a list of one vector and you say transpose, so I say, okay, the only thing I can transpose is a matrix, so it will be transformed to a matrix before applying the transpose operator, and then after transposing it, so I can use it. So, and of course, if you're really explicitly giving a matrix by this, so this is by rows, and you could do more than one row as well. Transpose comes after the fact, so that works. That's when I have two rows, one is z, the other is 3 times z. And, if you want to give the entries of the matrix explicitly, then there's a special syntax which allows you like this. It must be in the same length, but you have vertical bar in the middle, and then you also specify it by rows. So that's just for literally entering matrices